Okay, it's Monday, June, I don't remember the day anymore, but this is what happened after it flooded out here. The tomato plants, well, I'll go over there. Wait, first let me look what I did. We had grass and this was all muddy, and I was digging up trenches and everything for the plants so they wouldn't drown. I'd say about 65% of the garden was wiped out. All I've got is those squash right there. I've got two zucchini plants in the back out of four. I can't see with this viewfinder, of course, but anyway, they're back there. God, I can't see anything. Somewhere in there is four zucchini plants. Now, the kale kind of looked okay. Somewhere in there. My peas, out of 1, 2, 3, 6 pea plants, I think I have two. Beans, all the beans except for three. Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 bean plants right here. There were 6. One I just pulled up because it was just completely gone. The first one, and the first three have yellow leaves on them. I don't know if they're no good or what, but they got waterlogged over here. All of them except for that one right there. What would be the third one, now it's the second one. I can't see in this video. And there's a fresh one down here somewhere. A green leaf that was just starting up. I think that's it. Yeah, that's it. Okay. And that one there. And that's it. The rest of them are no good. One in the back there might make it. Then this, I just tilled it all up. Tall grass, there's grass all mixed inside this. I'm gonna make two rows here. There were four watermelon plants here. Of course, I destroyed one or two of them. Now I've got one in the front right there, I think, yeah. And you can't really see, I can't see the other one. It's back in there somewhere. This is just a waste. The two peanut plants look okay. I dug around them as much as I could without hurting them. I think that's one on the screen there, peanut, and another one back there somewhere. No, peanut plant, I don't know. And two peanut plants. Then over here, okra plants. There was quite a few of them. Now there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 okra plants. At one time I planted 14 of them. Nothing came up. I planted 6 or 7 seeds from the first okra crop we had from my mom's that were heirloom seeds that I had bought. And we saved the seeds from those okra from 2010. And we planted them out here, and that's what's growing up here now. There's 5 of them growing up. And the tomatoes, smaller plants are healthier than the older plants, even though they were all flooded. And you see the grass all throughout the garden. But see, I even have, I can't see it myself. There's some green tomatoes on one of the plants. I can't focus on it myself, but. Anyway, there's a tomato plant out there with a couple of green tomatoes on them. The rest of them, you see, they look like they've got too much moisture. They drown, basically. But they're gonna come back, some of them. Let's see, I had 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 11. I had 11 in cages, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 17 with staked ones. And of the 17, there's probably about 6 to 8 that are gonna make it. Plus I've got 9 more now fresh ones in pots that haven't even broke through the soil yet. And then peppers, I've got about 18 pepper plants in pots over there that are pretty good size. They're about the size of, I can see this, I'm in the shade, so I can see this a little bit better. Where's that other one? See that pepper plant right there? That's about 5 inches above the ground. And there's another one right there. It's about 6 inches, almost 7 inches above the ground. I can't see it really good still on the viewfinder, and I got bugs all over me, like fly, biting flies. But I've got about 18 or 20 peppers over there, plus one, two, I'm looking with my eyes here. One, two, three, four, five, six out here that are growing that are fairly decent. Okay, so got peppers and tomatoes look okay. The majority of them, at least half, I should say. The eggplant destroyed from the rain. The beans destroyed. The peas just about destroyed. The squash, some of the squashes are destroyed. Most of the okra destroyed. Of the pea plants out of six, I got two that were growing. Zucchini out of four, I've got two. Squash, I've got one, two, three, four. Those look decent. I had four watermelons. I only have two left. I actually ran over one of them when I was trying to till it up the ground. So that's how the garden looks now. You know, so this has got to dry out again. And believe it or not, somehow or another, I have to get out there with a hoe or something and make mounds. This time, everything will be planted on mounds. Learning my lesson. Remember, I'm a city boy trying to be country. And I planted everything in valleys, basically, and that's why it flooded like it did so bad. But overall, 65% of the garden is gone. The grass over there, all that right there, I'm just going to let it all grow out. There's peas over there, some kale, and two zucchini plants in the back. I'm going to harvest those, but then after that, right where the soil is right there, up to the beans right there, that's where the garden will be. That's about 26 feet across now, 26, 28 feet across, but still going to be 40 foot long. So if anything else, I'll divide 20 and 20, front and back of the garden, north and south. Because north is at that end, south is at this end. But that's it. That's the garden now. Trying to make it recover from the flooding. So much grass out here again. I don't want to use chemicals as a thing, and I was foolish, and all I did was use apple cider vinegar. I didn't use it with Epsom salt and Joy or Dawn dish detergent, which is what you're supposed to mix. Dummy me, Mr. City Boy. But I just used the vinegar, and I killed some grass off, but you know, duh, anything will die off from something like that, but it'll grow right back. So anyway, that's all mixed up right here. I'll try to get two rows out of that. There are two separate rows on that far side right over there too. You know, so that's four rows at least. And this okra right here, right where the onions are back there, back, all that's completely empty. I don't know what I'm gonna do with that, so we'll see. Thank you, man, God. Appreciate those chemtrails and the flooding. Thank you.